It's June, as you were, July 3rd, and it's day 114. It's 5:55, and pretty much we have a mission. there's a town 16 miles up called Salisbury. I'll be staying there. I got a ride coming on the 4th of July, Monday morning, to take me in, pick me up, take me to Dick's Sporting Goods so I can get some boots. And then back on point. But pretty much the theme of the day is everything for the next couple days, and not even that. The next 48 hours, it's about getting new boots and not about the trail. So all this, so basically 16 miles, we're doing what we have to do. But just because I got to go get some boots doesn't mean I can't extract what I can from the situation. So what does that mean? I did 17 miles yesterday. That's rest. I'm going to do 16 miles today. That's rest. While I'm resting, I can eat, you know, and while I'm resting and eating, well, I can network, politic, do what I need to do, you know, just make some movies, just do things. So capitalize the time. So that's a good thing too. And that's that. I got my fingers crossed that everything will work out as far as my ride showing up on time and me getting this boot situation taken care of. But at the end of the day, your boots are probably the most important part of your gear because they're pretty much what's keeping you up. You know, they can make or break your hike. They can keep you safe or they can trip you up real quick. And, you know, we already know how that goes. So, good morning. Let's knock this day 114 out. It should be an early day for me. Like I said, it's only 6 o'clock. I'm going kind of slow because the boot is like, it's like opening up. And so if I hit a rock wrong, it's just gonna exacerbate the problem. So I'm gonna measure my steps. We're gonna get down through here, out here. By the way, enough about me. There was a lot of people at that shelter. Some people I guess I really didn't know nobody, but they kind of knew me in a sense. At the last hostel, not the last hostel, but when I was pitching a tent at Bonnie's place, there were some people that were there. And since I zeroed to help her out, I guess there was another wave that came. So let's just say this, I recognize some faces. Yeah, that's probably the best way to put it. I recognize some faces there. But you know what? It warms my heart to know that there's still people out here. I didn't see anybody from Georgia, but then again, I really didn't interrogate anyone, so to speak. But just a lot of happy hikers. I pretty much stayed in my tent because I was tired. So I didn't really mingle. I just pretty much ate and went to bed. And then the rain came out here. All right, after turning on my phone, I got a text from Christine. She was the shuttle person. When we left, she said she was gonna, when we last talked, she said she was gonna do some investigation to figure out where's the closest store. Well, when I read the text this morning, she said that basically it'd be a 3.5 hour drive round trip to take me to Dick's Sporting Goods because it was an hour away from where we were going and she still has to come get me. But she also said that in Massachusetts, which is the direction that I'm going right now, that there's a Dick's Sporting Goods 2.5 miles off trail, you know, coming up here. And would that be the best option given the state of decay or dilapidation of my boots? And I thought about it and I'm thinking, sure, I can, these boots can last. I mean, I'll be in Massachusetts like maybe today or tomorrow. So I went on ahead and canceled that. And I don't have to do 16 today. I can just hike my hike, do 20, 26, whatever. Now the mission is get to Mass and handle these boots. So at some point, I just got to look in the book and see what's up. But that was very kind of her to do that investigative work, because not only are you looking at 3.5 hours in the car, which would be hard on her and myself, but you got to think about the money, the cost, you know, and it's just not worth it. So for all intents and purposes, we just gonna wait on that. So we got the day back and we're just gonna hike and do our thing out here. By the way, do you see how fast things change? Or you can go to bed with one plan, wake up something totally different based on a text. That's the way the trail is, it's fluid. You gotta be as flexible as you are versatile out here. So checkpoint Alpha is 10 miles from here. That's the next shelter. And from there is the town of Salisbury, maybe 6 miles up from that. And that's where I was gonna stop. We'll do lunch there. Then we'll hike out and crush a 20 and then stop somewhere along the way after that. When I get to this shelter, I'll get my sample, my soil sample for Connecticut, and then we'll go from there out here. It's 7 o'clock. According to this sign, I'm only 700 miles away from the top of Mount Katahdin, and that's Maine. Woohoo! If you haven't figured it out yet, I'm only getting better, stronger, and faster while I'm out here, okay? Or should I say, the longer I stay out here. And what that suggests is that the medicine that's in the woods is actually working. I'm receptive to it, that vibration. It's changing me all for the better, which is a good thing. You know what I'm saying? I can see it in my own self. I can see it in the relationships that I make with others, you know, because the love is just so great. You know what I mean? I mean, like that trail magic yesterday was crazy. I mean, I never saw that coming, but like I say, you know, and it's just such a good analogy. I have to bring it up again. If you're standing in a crowded elevator and somebody decides to spray themselves with perfume or cologne, it's impossible for a little bit of that mist not to fall on everybody else that's in the elevator. So when the elevator stops and you walk out, everybody's smelling like roses. The point I'm trying to make is that everything that the woods are doing to me, you know, this great environment, when I step into town, right, I'm bringing the woods with me. I'm bringing the energy, the spirit, the healing with me. And when I'm around people and when I make contact with people, that's what they sense, that's what they hear, and that's what they feel. Never mind the pack on my back. That's the obvious, you know, it's the obvious answer. Oh, you must be hiking. I see your pack. And while I can say yes, true enough, but there are also other signs, you know, that are not so visible, but are still even more so perceptible from a feeling standpoint. So I mean, I'm not saying I want to come out here and live in the woods and move out here. I'm a city boy at heart. But what I'm saying is, once you get in sync with this vibration, you can take it with you. You can live in that balance. And that's what righteousness means. It just means a balance between the two. Center, where God is out here. I just walked into Trail Magic. Who is this hosted by? I like Backtrack, and I like Maybe. Very creative names. Well, thank you very much. I am August. This is day 114. I started in Georgia, March 11th. Wow. Actually, check out that fat burrito. Oh my God. Thank you very much.
The Trail Magic was right on time. So, early lunch, it's 9:30. We're still heading out to that 10-mile shelter.
I'm looking at this while I trip over roots and I'm saying, really though? Is it truly wheelchair accessible? I don't know. That ivy's no joke. Looks like wallpaper taken right over the house. For real. This is old stuff.
Back
here.
Up again right after the bridge up here.
All right, thank you, sir. Old school stuff right here. You know what this reminds me of? Shutter Island. That movie with Leonardo DiCaprio. Kind of like just a weird movie. I can see this in the rain. If I was a director, I could pull it off. This is new trail to me because in 2015, this bridge is out. You can see that it's new, but this bridge was totally out. And what they did was they just had a detour taking you all the way through the city. What I did was I ignored the route and I tried to cross. And one of the workers there, a foreman or something, he's like, let me just get this guy out of here because, you know, if I don't, I'll have to watch him. And then he'll end up hurting himself on my shift. Guy put me in the back of his truck and shuttled me all the way around to the other end and dropped me off at the end of the bridge. Weirdest thing. Nice guy, but very smart. Very smart indeed. See how it looks new? Now look at the date on it. 2016. Because it was out in 2015. Color me impressed. This has the weight of Niagara Falls behind it, I must say. Now, I'm not calling it Buffalo, New York, but I've been there. And this is pretty impressive. I know this camera ain't doing it much justice, but yeah. Checkpoint Alpha. That's 10 miles in. I can't believe it's a half a mile off the trail. You can dig it. That's limestone shelter. Obviously, we're not going down there. Anyway, Checkpoint Alpha. What we're going to do now is let me check the books out here. All right, it's 11:45. I'm about 5 miles away from Salisbury. We're going to go in there, have lunch, and then shoot out and go from there. Out here. All right, just put Connecticut in there. So that's another state down. Tomorrow's 4th of July, and at some point tomorrow, I'm gonna pass into Massachusetts. So I was gonna do this at the shelter, but that shelter was a half mile off the trail. So I figure before I hit this road and go on into Salisbury for brunch, we'll call it, because it's 10 after one, I'm gonna go ahead and knock the dirt out. So another state down, that's Connecticut out here. It's 1:30, I'm in town. Let me just say this app is priceless. I just saw some goats on the way to the store. It's almost like a petting zoo. All right, let's find the store. If they have a grocery store, it's very well hidden. I'm seeing signs, but I see no. Oh, okay, I see it out here. It's almost like hidden in a cubby hole. Anyway, it's something. Yeah. How did you, where did you come out? I'll get myself till 2 o'clock and it's back in the woods with me. I got a rotisserie chicken, $2 off. That big chicken is $7. I got a big old thing of fresh sourdough bread, and I got some orange juice. So I got extra cheese left over. I got a bag of chips. I'm gonna eat a little bit, pack all this up, and that's dinner for tonight. I remember this place because back in 2015, a person that ran a hostel picked me up from this location, but their hostel wasn't listed because I was looking for a place to stay when I thought I needed shoes, so. I guess it is what it is out here. So it's 2:39. I took longer than I should have, but I ate well and I got dinner in my pack. Let's get to the trail out here. Whew. Okay, 20 miles later, here's the shelter. This is the last shelter in the great state of Connecticut. Tomorrow we will be in, you already know where we're gonna be. We'll be in Mass tomorrow. Ah, I may have the shelter to myself, and you know what that means. Wink, wink, nod, nod. All right, I gotta put some clothes on. These mosquitoes are biting. It's 5:30. Sourdough chicken sandwich with the two breasts, and then a bag of chips. Dinner of champions. Morning. Happy 4th of July. It's day 115. No towns today. We got to do 23 miles. We don't have to, but that's the plan anyway. So we're just going to blow through it and hike today on the 4th. And we'll be in a new state as well in about a mile or so. I'll keep you posted. It's a beautiful day out here. Time marker is about 12 after 6. This is our ascent to the border of Mass. Going up. Welcome to Massachusetts, state line. Happy 4th.
Taking a little siesta. Still eating on them chips, and I got another bag left. You know, as a general rule, I don't fear the unknown. I'm actually curious, you know. But and honestly, I find curiosity to be a virtue, but not without prudence. You know what I'm saying? I have found that if you push a positive hard enough, it will become negative. Why? Because force negates. But if you flip that, if you push a negative aspect, it will turn positive. It just has to, because within the whole, there is another side. There's not a cliff. This is life. Life is a circle. So basically, you can defeat a negative by endurance. By persistence, or by just straight pushing through it, not necessarily resistance, because that's what a negative is there to do. It's there to make you stop. You know what I'm saying? It's there to create that resistance. But you can persist, okay? You can be patient. But at the end of the day, it's like I'm saying before, I just see curiosity as a virtue.
And when you're living in the world, not necessarily as a minority, but it does apply. When you're living in a world where there are nothing but laws that are against you, and if you spell the word law backwards, it means wall. So when you have all these walls pressing in against you, okay, you can either stop or you can be curious and see what's behind them, okay? Because curiosity comes with its own little bag of tools. You know what I'm saying? It comes with persistence. It comes with a positive outlook. It comes with a tenacity. You know what I'm saying? That a person would not have if they aren't curious. You know what I'm saying? That's like the beginning of desire and whatnot. So, and honestly, hell, excuse my language, that's what led me to the Lord. I'm curious. One day I saw that thick Bible sitting there, and I read Lonesome Dove, and that's like a book by Larry McMurtry, and it's about as thick as the Bible, and I tossed it, and it landed right next to the Holy Bible, and I'm like, you know what? They're about the same size. If I can read that, I can read that. And so I just went with the curiosity and just read it. Changed my life. The Bible, I'm saying. So, yeah. It's not without its virtues, you know? And you never really gain anything through fear as far as fearing the unknown goes, you know? Yeah. I'll tell you one last story, then I'll go. I realize I'm babbling. When I was in Hawaii, I saw a buddy of mine. I was working at Red Lobster. I saw a buddy of mine eating sushi. And I'm like, man, that is crazy, dude. That's not raw fish. That's dead fish. And I was just like pushing on him. He's like, no, it's good. Try the kind. And I'm like, yeah, whatever. So I was in Red Lobster. So homeboy opened up the thing. He pulled out some ahi tuna. He took a nice sharp knife and he cut a little piece of it. He put it on the edge of the knife. He's like, I dare you to eat this. I'm like, you don't gotta dare me. I'm not touching that, right? He's like, no, try it. I'm telling you. And then he took off a slice and he ate it, right? And I'm like, you know, me being a little bit curious and, you know, prudence and all this. So I tasted it. I took the piece and I gotta tell you, best thing I ever tasted in my life. I was like, I could not believe it. It was excellent. Did I eat another piece? No. Why? Because it's dead fish. But the point I'm trying to say is that it was very good. I understand why people eat sushi. You know what I'm saying? Especially ahi, you know. So, yeah, you can't be afraid to broaden your horizons. You never know. And at the end of the day, even if it's not for you, or if you don't continue to partake, at least you understand the motivation behind everybody else. You know what I mean? You don't have to look at them like they're different. And you don't have to judge them or have a reason to judge them. You know? All right, out here. Just to square that circle, let me say this emphatically. You will never hear me say that I will try anything once. That is a fool's errand, all right? Why do you say that? Because death is one mistake away, no matter how you look at it. It could be. But at the end of the day, I have an idea of where I want to go. I have goals. I have plans. All right. And so if you're saying you'll try anything, there are some things that will work diametrically opposite to where you want to go. So I would think that that's a fool's errand. I think a person with absolutely no direction in their life can make a statement like that and probably mean every single word. But no, don't mistake my curious nature for a type of person that would do anything, you know what I'm saying? Try anything once. That is not me, not even close. Okay, out here. Lastly, in the realm of goal setting, let me just say that having a known point in your life is probably the ultimate blessing. What do you mean? Having something that you can strive for, no matter how far it's out of reach, you know, something that you can hold in your mind's eye, you know, that is all the direction you will ever need. Because as long as you persist and you go forward and you do everything that it takes to stay on that path, you're going to get there. That's a tether. Can you imagine just going around in circles and not even know you're moving in circles? Can you imagine just walking around having nothing? Nothing to strive for, nothing to think about, nothing to reach for. It's like, what's the point? I get it. That right there is the beginning of depression. Not having a goal, not having a direction. Why are you here? You know, and you best believe there's going to be a voice in the back of your mind asking you every single day when you wake up, what are you waking up for? You know what I'm saying? Why are we here? You know, why are you wasting my time? There are voices back there. Trust me. You know I'm telling the truth, and that's why you're depressed, because you can't answer that question. So yeah, so if you're being curious, if you're looking around, if you're venturing out, if you're seeking, you're going to find something. I guarantee it. All right, let me shut up. Out here. This is actually Mohican country. Remember the movie Last of the Mohicans? Yeah, Massachusetts. This is the stomping ground. Beautiful movie, by the way. 1994, Daniel Day-Lewis. As you were, 1992, Daniel Day-Lewis. It's almost 10 o'clock, and I haven't even gone 7 miles. And 10 would be 4 hours. That's a testament to the difficulty of this terrain. I've been climbing all day. I'm on a mountaintop right now. I'm about to go down and climb another one. Point I'm trying to say is I will not be doing 23 miles on this day. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leverage. In 17 miles, I may as well go into town. I ain't gonna do nothing else. So I'll go into Great Barrington and then eat something, whatever, hike out, and then pitch. Out here. You want to know what's ironic? And when I say contrary to popular belief, just understand that the popular belief is probably the one held by most of the ignorant, because there are more ignorant people in the world than there are learned. So just remember that when you're trying to follow the wisdom of the crowd, so to speak. But the point I want to say is that an open heart, a heart that is truly open, can't be broken. The only heart that can be broken is a closed heart, that's why it's fractured and closed and all that. So somebody could say, oh, I loved you and he broke my heart. No, because if you loved them and your heart was open, they would never be able to break it. See, the thing about an open heart is it's continual acceptance. Okay. It's acceptance of the bad and the good. And that's not to say that you can't walk away from a bad relationship. It's just that you can accept the facts that you're looking at. You could take that lesson and you can move on. There is no grief about it. And one more thing, an open heart is an open consciousness. So you see more from that open perspective. You have a higher vantage point, and it's easier to see something coming way down the way. For example, an open heart can be like, yeah, I can see down the road that we're not gonna be compatible, you know, and there's no grief in that. It's a statement, a fact. It's kind of like a short person being mad every time somebody call them little. My attitude is, why are you ashamed in the truth? Dude, you're small. Accept it. You know, that's not a curse. That's the truth. And so at the end of the day, that's how we have to look at ourselves. And it doesn't have to be a shortcoming. It's just a truth. So when you can accept the facts that are in your life, just accept the facts, you'll have, that'll be the end of anxiety. You know, it's kind of like, I can give you one example after the other, but the point I'm trying to make is simple. An open heart can't be broken. That's all. Okay, out here. Notice the connotation, Mount Everett summit. And I tell you what, it felt just like it. Just like it. Whew. Well, that right there is Checkpoint Alpha. And believe it or not, it took me 5 hours and 15 minutes to traverse about 8.5-9 miles. And trust me, I'm not dragging my feet. The terrain is just very strenuous out here. I just passed some southbounders and I'm like, do you know what trail magic is? And the guy's like, huh? And so I saw his wife and I'm like, is there anybody at this road feeding hikers? She said, yeah. They're having a party down there. I'm like, that's what I'm talking about. So there's trail magic ahead out here. The trail magic means I don't have to go into Great Barrington. I mean, I just wanted to get a feed in because this is a very arduous hike. Like, for real. It's 1218, but I might be at 11 miles right now. It's just the terrain. You know, at the end of the day, it's the terrain that dictates. It doesn't matter how strong you are or what your goals are. So, anyway, looking forward to eating out here. Going down. I'm at the road and all I hear are crickets. That lady said there was a party down here. Let's take a look. Yeah, I don't see nothing. Do you see something? I see a van. I'll check. Got no problem knocking on that door out here. Okay, I talked to a van that's been here all day. He said he hadn't seen anything. So, either I'm at the wrong road, which I doubt, or that lady just pulled my leg. No big deal. Out here. For the record, that is rare. I mean, why would civilians, some old lady, lie about trail magic, talking about there's a party at the road? I've never seen that happen before, but I guess there's a first time for everything. Out here. And that case is back on. We're going to go into Great Barrington, eat, hike out, and do what we can. Today has been a good hike, boy. It's 106. Great Barrington is 17 miles. The road, at least the Great Barrington, is 17 miles, was from the front. The next time I hit a landmark, and honestly, I don't have to because I have this awesome app, but the next street I hit, because I know there's one coming up, I'm going to pull out the app and see what's up out here. All right, I'm 2 miles from Route 7, where you go to the left, you're in Great Barrington. I just passed another southbounder, and she told me there is a tent about a mile up before you get to the road with trail magic. They're talking about hamburgers, cell phone chargers, everything. So maybe that other lady wasn't wrong, but she definitely got the road wrong. But, you know, we'll see, because it just didn't make sense. I mean, who would lie about trail magic? It's like, really, Grandma? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, we will see here in a second out here. This might be trail magic. Hey, are you guys doing trail magic? Okay, cool. Yeah, we're doing trail magic.
We're just packing up, so I don't have anything hot for you, but we have water and we have snacks.
I'll take whatever. I'm good.
Yeah, go right up that pathway.
Okay. She said they're just packing up. I just made it. I'll take whatever you have.
Okay.
Okay. Got the video on. Okay, the world will see it.
Yep. Now this way, when you get up there, you gotta...
They were packing up as I came. I got what I could, and they popped smoke and broke camp. Just like that. It's 4th of July. Everybody trying to get out and be with their family. I get it. I got enough food and baggies and whatnot that I don't have to go into Fort Barrington. Or Barrington. Great Barrington. So right now, I'm hovering at about 17 miles. I'm just gonna hit the road and keep hiking. It's 3 o'clock out here. All right, this is the road to Great Barrington. Because of the trail magic, oh, by the way, I'm 17 miles in at this road. I did a grab bag. I just took what I could. I got like 6 hard-boiled eggs, some cookies, some chips. So at the end of the day, long story short, I should be able to do 23. I only got 6 more miles to do. So right now it's 3:18. I'm gonna sit here and stuff my face until 3:30. And then I'm gonna knock out this last 6 miles, and that'll be 23 for the day out here. So I was sitting on the side of the road minding my own business, and The same lady that was doing the trail magic saw me sitting here. She picked me up, took me to the gas station where I got a gallon of water, some tortillas, and some chicken. Some like chicken for like a sandwich. So I'm gonna sit right here till 4 o'clock now. I was gonna leave at 3:30, it's 3:45. I'm gonna make a couple of wraps and then I'm gonna head out. So excellent 4th of July, I must say, out here. All right, it's 4 o'clock, back in the woods. I'm paying it forward. I found a hat. I've been carrying that for like 10 miles, just in case they got off in Fort Barrington. I'm gonna leave that there so they'll find it when they come back. I got tortillas in that bag, as well as some extra food, and I left some water. So that'll help out the next hiker coming just behind me, because it is hot today, trust me. Now, it's 4:02. Only got 6 more miles to do, and we can cash in for 23 miles on the day. And welcome to Massachusetts and 4th of July and all that out here. Feel like the last man on earth. And yet they're talking about a bubble, woo, of hikers. You know, for the record, there are echoes of COVID, you know, on the trail. It's not all forgotten. But what I've noticed is the further north you get, the least people care, if that makes any sense about it. So I imagine by the time I get to New Hampshire and Maine, it won't even be a ceremony. It would be nothing at all, for real, which is a good thing. I've been getting picked up so many times out here, It's beautiful. Nobody's wearing a mask. None of that. You know what's weird, though? I mean, I'm not a dog, but it just seems like there's a high frequency of people commenting about me being attractive. Now, I'm not used to that, so I guess maybe I'll blush or whatever, but it's weird, dude. I mean, when I'm out there in the world, I may as well be a frog. Nobody paying attention to me. I get out here and it's like I'm Billy D. Williams, you know what I'm saying? And it's just weird, because I, like, just at this trail magic, I was trying to get into town and this woman's 74 years old. Oh, you're so handsome, anybody will stop for you. And I'm like, really? Did you have to put me on spot like that? But anyway. You know what I think, though? I think that because I'm in my element and I'm just being cleansed, they're just seeing my aura. Does that make sense? Because it's like, excuse my language, but you're familiar with resting bitch face, right? Where you just like go to the DMV and these women just look at you like, what the? Well, I imagine guys have that too. Maybe it's not the same, but people always, like, when I'd be working or something, they'd be like, why are you mad? And be like, what are you talking about? It's like you're wearing a scowl. But that's what society does to you. Maybe it's because my features have relaxed. I'm just glowing. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's just my theory. I don't know. Anyway, it's 6:37. I'm a mile away from 23 miles, which is very good. Very good. I didn't even see that coming today. But I was able to get that fuel and that trail magic. And one thing I wanted to say about that, as you can see, it's not like I'm Grizzly Adams out here. It seems like every day I'm crossing the street, I'm having breakfast in the town, I'm this, that, and the other. So if you're thinking about, ooh, I don't want to go in the outback and no showers and I got to eat dry food, man, I ain't ate out of my food pack and I don't know how long. It's all about a budget. If your budget can afford it, you don't even have to carry no food. You just hit a road section and with this app, it tells you everything you need to know. Hours, you can call, you can do whatever. So it's not like you have to rough it. Just keep that in mind. You don't have to rough it out here. You can eat regular food. And this has to be, and this is the weirdest part too, this has to be the easiest hitch, the easiest season for me to just pick up rides, you know, where I don't have a have an issue trying to hitch or something like that. And that was one of my major concerns. So that's just off the table. That's not a problem. And the other major concern I had was climate change. Well, that's off the table. This is beautiful weather. I mean, I can probably count on my hand how many times it's rained, which is beautiful. Which is beautiful. I don't want to jinx it because Vermud, meaning Vermont's coming up. That's my next state. Speaking of which, I'm going to get my soil sample when I hit this shelter in Massachusetts. Why it's on my mind. You know, 4th of July is a ceremonial time, and this is my first day in Massachusetts, and I'm knocking out a 23-mile day, which was very hard. That first 5 hours, I only covered 7 miles, so I'm telling you, that Mount Everett, boy, it ain't no joke, like for real. All right, out here. Incidentally, that lady that had the crush on me in Trail Magic, she was the one that left. I'm hiking. I'm sitting on the side of the road eating whatever scraps I had for lunch. And she like pulls over. So basically she had left. She's going, she did something. She was coming back and this car pulls over. And I'm like, that's odd. I'm not hitchhiking. And so I get up to say, hey, I'm okay. And it's her. And she's like, what do you need? I can take it down to blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay then, let's ride, you know? So that helped with the tortillas and all that other stuff. So that was cool. I mean, I will take a W wherever I can get it. That's a win. All right. All right. This day was hard won, but it's there. 13 hours later, here's the shelter. Let's go down. It's 7 o'clock. 23.4. That's what we put up today. I want every single point out here. Like I'm in a canyon. What up, Smiley? Water's a quarter mile down. I'm about to go get it. It's about 7:30. I'm running out of daylight out here. It's exactly 8 o'clock. It's well past my bedtime. I tell you what. Anyway, Massachusetts is set. I got them. I got three more states left, and we'll be done with our collection of the AT out here. I'm going to go ahead and close this day out. Oh, it's been a beautiful day. July 4th, day 115. We did, I'm going to go ahead and call it 24 because that water was not close. 24 miles on the day. It's 8 o'clock. I'm just going to eat and then call it a day. But it was good. It was good. I had fun today. I mean, it was hard, but it really wasn't that hard. All right. I will see you guys tomorrow. On day July 5th, 116. You can be the best. You can be the king.